हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द यूट्यूब चैनल ऑफ सेंट विल्फ्रेड कॉलेज ऑफ आर्ट्स कॉमर्स एंड साइंस पनवेल। इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस दिस सम प्रैक्टिकल प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन ए फाइनल अकाउंट, पार्टनरशिप फाइनल अकाउंट। इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी विल प्रिपेयर द बेसिक प्रॉब्लम ऑन ए पार्टनरशिप फाइनल अकाउंट। ओके, सी द क्वेश्चन। फ्रॉम द फॉलोइंग ट्रायल बैलेंस ऑफ अजीत एंड सुजीत, दिस इज अ ट्रायल बैलेंस ऑफ अजीत एंड सुजीत। You are required to prepare the trading and profit and loss account for the year ended 31st March 2012 and balance sheet as on that date. You are required to prepare what? You are required to prepare a final account. In final account, which account should prepare? Trading account, profit and loss account, and balance sheet. Now see the trial balance. In a trial balance, capital balance is given. Capital balance of Ajit and Sujit is given. Then drawings of Sujit and Ajit is given, stock, opening stock is given, bills receivable, purchases and sales, returns, debit side return, it means return inward, means return of sales, and it credit side return, it means return of purchase, clear? Returns of debit side, it means return of sales return. Debit side return means sales return and credit side return is purchase return. Next is salary is given, carriage outward, wages, insurance, discount received, postage, debtors and creditors, furniture, cash in hand, machinery, train freight and taxes, and printing and stationery. These are the items are given. So tell me. Capital account means which side you should write capital account. See, capital account balance is given in a credit side. So this item will come capital account credit side by balance brought down. Next is drawing given in a debit side. So drawing comes capital account debit side. Next, stock. This is opening stock. Where the opening stock will come? Trading account debit side. Bills receivable, asset side. Purchases, trading account debit side. Sales, trading account credit side. Return, debit side return means sales return, less from sales. Credit side return, it means return, purchase return, less from purchase. Next is salary. Salary come under profit and loss account debit side. Carriage outward, profit and loss account debit side. Wages, trading account debit side. Insurance, profit and loss account debit side. Discount received, profit and loss account credit side. Postage, profit and loss account debit side. Debtors in asset side and creditors in a liability side. Furniture, asset side. Cash in hand, asset side. Machinery, asset side. Rent rate and taxes, profit and loss debit side. Yes, because this is the office expense. Printing and stationery, profit and loss account debit side. Already which item come under the which account, in which account I already given in a first lecture. Okay, which items come under which accounts. So you need to understand the format first, then you can easily classify the item. Now see the adjustment. Some adjustments are given. First of closing stock. Already two effects of closing stock already I given in a last lecture. So what will be the two effects of closing stock? First effect of closing stock is trading account credit side, and second effect in asset side. Next is outstanding. See, adjustment is given on wages and salary. So tick mark on wages and salary. Tick mark on wages and salaries. Tick mark on salary also, because adjustment is given. Adjust jis item ke upar adjustment di hai, that item should write in inner column. Outstanding means what? Add in salary and wages, and second effect in a liability side. Next is goods of rupees 2000 were distributed as a free sample. Free sample, it means what? Free sample means advertisement. Free sample means what? Advertisement. What will be the first effect? Trading account credit side. And what will be the second effect? P&L account debit side. Now, interest on partner's capital 7% means partner's capital 7% interest should be charged on a capital amount of partners. First effect. What will be the first effect? capital account credit side, and second effect profit and loss appropriation account debit side. Because we already discussed whatever adjustment regarding the partners come under the profit and loss appropriation account. So first effect of interest on capital is capital account credit side, and second effect profit and loss appropriation account debit side. Clear? Now, prepaid insurance. So adjustment is given on insurance. So tick mark on insurance. Tick mark on insurance, because this item ke upar adjustment is given, that item should write in inner column. So prepaid. What will the first effect of prepaid? Less from insurance. And second effect, write in asset side. Now depreciation. Depre on furniture and machinery. So tick mark on depre on furniture. Tick mark on furniture and tick mark on machinery. And tick mark on machinery also. So what will the first effect of depreciation? Less from asset. And second effect of depreciation? P&L account debit side. Clear? All of you understood which item should write in which column and how to prepare the adjustment. Now we will start the solution. So prepare the, prepare the columns of trading account, profit and loss account, profit and appropriation account, and capital account, and balance sheet. Prepare all these columns. Now, do the postings. First is what capital? So write in capital account, Ajit and Sujit. So write in capital account. Where is your capital account? All such accounts prepare approximately 10 to 15 lines. Capital account prepare for the 10 lines, for the 5 lines. By balance brought down. See the amount of Ajit. How much the amount of Ajit? 60,000. How much the amount of Sujit? 40,000. So write down 60,000 and 40,000. Clear? Now next. Next is what? Drawing. So drawing comes where? Drawing will come capital account debit side. So two drawings. Two drawings. Ajit. Ajit. Two drawings of Ajit. How much drawings of Ajit? 2,000. And Sujit? 1,000. So write down 2,000 and 1,000. Clear? Now next posting. Next is stock. As on 1st January 2012. The stock on 1st April 2000. First stock on 1st April 2011. Amount is 44,000. So this is the opening stock. Opening stock will come in which account? Opening stock will come in a trading account. So two opening stock. How much the amount? See, how much the amount of opening stock? 44,000. So write down 44,000. First, do all the postings. Next is bills receivable. Bills receivable come under asset side. So write down in asset side bills receivable. Some lines leave for the fixed asset. Or leave nahi kiya tobe chalega. Write down. Bills receivable. Bills receivable. How much the amount of bills receivable? See in a question. How much the amount of bills receivable? 1,800. Write down 1,800. So next. Next is purchase. Purchase is 1,90,000. So write down purchase in a trading account. Two purchases. Write in inner column, because inward return inward is given 1,90,000. Why? Because purchase return is given. Next is sales. Sales is 3,02,000. So write down here buy sales. Buy sales. Write in inner column 3,02,000, because sales return is given. So next is returns. Return, how much? Return 6,000 rupees means this is a sales return. So less from sales, less return, how much? 6,000. After less, write down the amount in outer column. 3,002,000 minus 6,000. Then how much will be the amount? 2,96,000. Now, next, less purchase return. See the amount of how much the purchase return is given? Purchase return of rupees 2,000. Because credit side returns, it means purchase return. 2,000. So write down 1,90,000 minus 2,000. Then how much will be the amount? 1,88,000. Write down 1,88,000. Then next. Next is salary. On salary, adjustment is given. So salary write in inner column. Salary come in P&L account. So two salaries. So salaries write in inner column. How much the amount? 10,000. So 10,000 write in inner column. Do one line after salary. Now next. And do underline like this. Next is Carriage outward also come in a P&L account debit side. Two carriage outwards. To carriage outward, how much the amount? To carriage outwards, 1,400. Write down 1,400. Now next. Next is wages. On wages, adjustment is given. So, two wages, write in inner column. Adjustment is given. So, wages write in inner column. How much the amount of wages? 24,000. So, write down 24,000 in inner column. Leave one line after wages because adjustment is given on wages. And also draw the underline like this. Now, next item is which? Next item is insurance. On insurance, adjustment is given. Insurance come under P&L account debit side. So, two insurance, write in inner column. Write in inner side, insurance 1,600. 1,600, write in inner column and do the underline after one line. Next. Discount received come under P&L account credit side. So by discount received, because discount received is our income. So discount received right in credit side. Discount received, how much the amount of discount received? 200. So write down 200. Now next item is postage. Postage come under P&L account debit side. So, two postage. How much the amount of postage? 800. Write down 800. Now, next item. After postage, debtors. So, write down debtors in asset side. Debtors, how much the amount of debtors? No adjustment is given on a debtors. So debtors write in directly in outer column. 70,400. And creditors in a liability side. Creditors, how much the amount of creditors? On creditors also no adjustment is given. So, creditor write in outer column, 64,200. Now, next item. See the next item? Furniture. Write down furniture in asset side. On furniture, adjustment is given. So, furniture write in inner column. How much the amount of furniture? furniture is 24,000. Write down 24,000 in inner column. After that, leave one line and do the underline. Next. Next is cash in hand. Cash in hand is also in asset side. Cash in hand. How much the amount of cash in hand? See, 9,800. 9,800. Now next. Next adjustment. Next item is machinery. Machinery come under asset side. So machinery, write in inner column because on machinery adjustment is given. So how much the amount of machinery? 80,000. So 80,000 write in inner column. After one line, do the underline. Next. Next item is rent and rate and taxes. Rent and taxes in P&L account debit side. So write down to rent and taxes. To rent and taxes, how much the amount of rent and taxes? Rent and taxes 1,200. 1,200. Next. Next amount. Next is printing and stationery. Printing and stationery, write down to printing and stationery P&L account debit side. Printing and stationery. Printing and stationery, how much the amount of printing and stationery? Printing and stationery 400. So write down 400. Now next item. See the next item. Printing and stationery. Okay. Now all posting will finish. Clear? How to post the items? Understood? One by one, post the item in a particular account. So, which item come in a which account? So, that purpose you need to understood the format. That format I already discussed in the last lecture. So, you learn or understand the format very well. Then you can easily post the items. Now, next, we start the adjustment. What is the first adjustment? First adjustment is closing stock as on 31st December 2013, valued at rupees 20, the first March. 31st March, valued at rupees 56,000. How much the value of closing stock? 56,000. What will be the two effects of closing stock? What will be the two effects of closing stock? First effect, trading account credit side. So write down by closing stock. How much the amount of closing stock? 56,000. Right na? 56,000. And second effect of closing stock? Yes, tell. Second effect of closing stock in a asset side. Yes, closing stock. Write down closing stock. How much the amount of closing stock? 56,000. Yes, right. Next. Outstanding wages. 2,000 rupees. So first effect of outstanding, add in wages. So add in wages. Outstanding. How much the amount? 2,000 rupees. So 24,000 plus 2,000, 26,000. And second effect of outstanding in a liability side. So write down outstanding wages, 2,000 rupees. Okay. Next is outstanding salary 930. So write down in salaries, add in salaries plus outstanding salaries. How much the amount of outstanding salaries? 930. So amount, add the amount 930, 10,000 plus 930, 10,000, 930. Second effect of outstanding in liability side. So do the second effect. Outstanding salaries amount 930. So next adjustment, So every adjustment having a two effects. These, okay, one effect in a debit side, then another effect in a credit side. Okay, always remember, every adjustments having two effects. One effect in a debit side, one effect in a credit side. Always remember. Now, goods of rupees 2000 were distributed as a free sample. Means advertisement. So first effect of goods distributed as a free sample. First effect in a trading account credit side by goods distributed as free sample. As a free sample. Amount. How much will be the amount? 2000 rupees. So write down 2000. And next is second effect. Free sample, it means what? Free sample means advertising. Then second effect of advertising in P&L account debit side to advertisement amount of rupees 2000. Amount of rupees 2000. Clear? Now next. Next adjustment number 4. Interest on partner's capital 7%. So calculate the interest on partner's capital 7%. How much the partner's capital? See, 60,000. So first effect of interest on capital on credit side of capital account by interest on capital. Capital account credit side. So 60,000 into 7%. Calculate the interest. 60,000 into 7% means 7%. 4,200 and 40,000 into 7%, 2,800. Clear? Now second effect. Second effect in a profit and loss appropriation account debit side. Because first effect in a credit side means another effect in a debit side. To interest on capital. Interest on capital. Ajit. How much the amount? 4,200. And next is Sujit. Sujit amount 2,800. Do the plus. Add the amounts and write in outer column. Means total 7,000. 7,000. Right? Total 7,000. Now next adjustment. Clear? Next adjustment is prepaid insurance rupees 100. Prepaid insurance. Prepaid means less from insurance. See, where is insurance? Insurance in a P&L account debit side. Less prepaid. Less prepaid. How much the amount? 100. So 1600 minus 100. It means 1500. And second effect of prepaid in which side? Second effect of prepaid in a asset side. So do the second effect. Prepaid insurance. Prepaid insurance. Prepaid insurance 100. Clear? Now next. Next is depreciation on furniture 10%. So calculate the depreciation on furniture 10%. Less depreciation 10%. 2400. 24,000. Minus 2,400, it means 21,600. And second effect in a P&L account debit side. So do the second effect to depreciation on furniture. To depreciation on furniture, how much the amount? Depreciation on furniture, 2,400. Now next is depreciation on machinery. So less depreciation on machinery, less depreciation. You can write a depreciation whole also or depre also. But write down depreciation whole. But I write a depre. You can write a depreciation 5% on machinery. See how much the amount? 80,000. So 5% of 80,000 is 4,000. Means 80,000 minus 4,000 in outer column, 76,000. Clear? Now second effect. Second effect of depreciation in P&L account debit side to depreciation on machinery. Depreciation on machinery, how much the amount? 4,000 4000. Clear? Now second adjust, next adjustment. This is the last adjustment. See, reserve for doubtful debt is to be created 5% on debtors. Reserve for doubtful debt, 5% on debtors. So, see, where is the debtors? Okay. Debtors, we need to write in an inner column. Okay. I write next line because I not leave the one line for debtors. Debtors, how much the amount of debtors say in a question? 70,400. So 70,400. Now depre on debt RDD. New RDD on debtors. New RDD on debtors. See the amount. How much? RDD 5% on debtor. So 70,400 of into 5% means 3,520, and 70,400 minus 3,520 means outer column mein 66,880. Clear? Now second effect in a P&L account. Debit side, P&L account in debit side, new RDD. How much the amount of new RDD? New RDD, 3,520 in outer column, 3,520. Okay, clear second effect? First effect less from debtors. Second effect P&L account debit side. Now see, all the adjustments are finished. First adjustment closing stock we done. Outstanding. Next, distributed as a free sample. Partners capital, prepaid insurance, depreciation and reserve for doubtful debt. All adjustments are finished. Now close the account. First close the trading account. How much the total of trading account? 3,54,000. So what will the total of trading account? 3,54,000. Difference will come in a debit side. It means our profit to gross profit. To gross profit carried down 96,000. Clear? Now corresponding effect in a P&L account credit side. By gross profit brought down. Corresponding side. Gross profit brought down 96,000. Clear? Now close the P&L account. Do the total of P&L account first. Total of P&L account is 96,200. See, total of P&L account is 96,200. Difference will come in a debit side. So, to net profit carried down. How much the amount of net profit carried down? 68,050. Okay. Now next, this carried down, brought down in a appropriation account by net profit. Brought down. How much the amount? 68,050. Now, close the profit and loss appropriation account. How much total? 68,050. Now, difference will come in a debit side. It means to net profit transfer to transfer to capital account, transfer to capital. Okay, now Ajit and Sujit. Now, how much the difference? Difference is 61,050. Now, this amount is distributed in their profit sharing ratio. See, profit sharing ratio is given in this question. No, profit sharing ratio is not given. So, distribute the amount on their capital ratio. On the basis of capital ratio, means see the capital balance of Ajit 60,000. Capital balance of Sujit is 40,000. Then ratio will be 3:2. So distribute this amount in a 3:2 ratio. So distribute this amount in 3:2 ratio. But no, this information is given. So distribute the, no any information is given. If profit sharing ratio is not given, distribute the amount of capital ratio. This information is also not given. So at this time, distribute the amount equally. So at this time, what shall you do? Distribute the amount equally. 30,525. Clear? Now, this net profit brought down in a capital account by net profit brought down. Net profit brought down. How much? 30,525. Sujit also 30,525. Now, tally the capital account and find out the difference. How much is the total of capital account? Do the total of capital account now. How much the amount? Total, see, 60,000 plus 4,200 plus 30,525. Then what will be the total? 94,725. This is the total of Ajit. What will be the total of Sujit? 40,000. Plus 2,800 plus 30,525. Then total will be 73,325. Yes. This is the total. 94,725 and 73,325. Now find out the difference. To balance carried down, and difference will be how much? The difference, of Ajit, 92,725, and difference of Sujit, 72,320. Five. Clear? Now carried down amount write in liability side. Write down capital. Capital. In that write down Ajit. How much the amount of Ajit? 92,725. And next is Sujit. How much the amount of Sujit? 72,325. Clear? Now tally the balance sheet. Now see the total of liability side. How much is total of liability side? 2,32,180. 2,32,180. Liability of asset side, 2,32,180. It means our solution is right. Clear? How to solve the problem? First, do the posting. Which item will come in which account? I already given in the last lecture. So, see that format and post the items. After posting, do the adjustments one by one. Then, after adjustment, close the trading account. Then, profit and loss account. then profit and loss appropriation account, then capital account, and then balance sheet. If your balance sheet totally same of both the side, it means your solution will be correct. Your solution is right. Clear? Now, the next topic of this chapter, that is admission of partners, we will discuss in the next video. Okay? So, thank you.